Hello and welcome back to another Red River Gorge video. Today we're going to be doing Buzzard's Roost North and South. This is going to be a good one for overlooks, and it's a pretty short one. So if you don't have a lot of time and you're in the Skybridge area, this trail is definitely for you. Right now, we are going to start off at the Skybridge picnic ground. And what we're going to do is we're going to go all the way to the end of the parking lot, and that is where our trail begins. So there's a couple different ways to get to this trail from the end of the parking lot. You can either go around like I just did, or you can just take the direct path. The main thing is there's this picnic table here, so you just want to get past that, and then the trail keeps going that way. After about 250 feet, you're going to get to this sign that says restoration area, and there's going to be a fork. So there's two trails here. There's Buzzard's Roost North and South. North goes that way to the right of the fork. South goes to the left. We're going to be doing both today, but if you only have time to do one of them, you should absolutely do the southern one because the views are a lot better. So we're going to go to the north first and then go to the south, but like I said, if you only have time to do one, definitely go south. If you decide to go north, just be mindful there was a forest fire here in 2019, so there's a whole bunch of rhododendron that burned down and they're kind of blocking the path. So if this is something you want to do, just be aware that there's going to be a lot of deadfall. And after following the ridge for a bit, you're eventually going to get to some pretty cool views. We've got a little bit more ways to go down there, but it's a nice little appetizer before the show starts right here. Once you get to the end of the ridge, there's going to be this little stick with orange tape on it. I'm kind of taking that as the end of the trail. There's some more, it looks like, down there. It may involve some scrambling and rock climbing and stuff. It's a little slippery out today, so I'm going to avoid those areas. But the view here is pretty nice. But Buzzard's Roost South is definitely going to be better. We got some more views over there. So overall, pretty cool. We've got a nice view of 715 right there, 715. And then Skybridge area is right over there. So we're pretty close to all this kind of stuff. But what I'm gonna do now is turn around, come back the way I came, and I'm gonna go over to Buzzard's Roost South. So now we're back to the first fork. Instead of taking a right, we're going to take a left and go to Buzzard's Roost South. And you'll know you're going the right way when you come down this hill and there's a little bit of a landing spot here. And you can see the preview of what is to come on this amazing little unofficial trail here at the Red. Then from there, all you have to do is there's a little bit of a, not quite a scramble, but there's a little bit of a rock feature that you can go through, and you just cross that, and then you make your way up here. If you don't want to go all the way up there, that's fine. The view from here is really, really good, and I'm not sure how well it's showing up on camera. We have the Red River here. It looks like this is Osborne Bend, and then Moonshiner's Arch is somewhere over there. I think that rock is Hen's Nest, one of those two. But yeah, very awesome view. There's 715 right there. The Copperas Valley area is right over there. So if you know where Copperas Creek Falls are, that's kind of the top level view of that. So very cool stuff. I believe actually that we just came from right there. So that would make that the Hen's Nest. So yeah, Red River, you got Osborne Bend, a lot of cool stuff. You can get an even better view from climbing up there, which is looking pretty dry right now, which is nice, especially on this snowy day. And you can kind of see I've got my rope out right there. There's a way It's not that bad, but I have it just in case because of the snow. And there's some cool little rock shelters down here, so I'm gonna go check that out in just a few. And here's the view from up top of that rock I was pointing out earlier. It's actually not that bad to get to, even though it's kind of covered in snow. It looks like you can get all the way down there. I'm going to refrain from that today, given the weather conditions, although that hasn't stopped me from getting up here. I'm gonna do that, get down, and then I'm gonna go down that way, check out the rock shelter. But yeah, this is a superb view of everything. And there's the Copperas Valley in full view, so it's a lot nicer. And yeah, very, very interesting that you can see kind of everything in one panoramic area. So there's the Red River again, all that kind of stuff. So I'm going to get down from here, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the rock shelters below. Climbing down wasn't that bad. It was actually pretty straightforward. You just go down with the rope. There's a nice little scuttle, and it reveals to us a pretty decent little rock shelter area. You guys saw earlier there was a nice little arch that we saw. And yeah, it's pretty cool, so I definitely recommend checking this little area out whenever you get here. And we got some nice icicles forming here because of the ice and the cold weather. And look what I have stumbled upon here. This is completely unplanned. We have the Red River Gorge guest book, and of course we have some interesting comments and all of here, but yeah, very cool stuff. Looking for a pen, which I unfortunately don't see, but yeah, if you come here and you turn left, you'll be able to find this little Red River Gorge guidebook notebook where you can sign in. Going past the guidebook or the logbook area, it's very neat. There's a whole bunch of icicles, which obviously are not going to be here every season. This tree is really cool, and a lot of cool ice we have going on around here. So this whole little rock shelter area is pretty neat. I'm really enjoying everything so far, and once I kind of explore this area, I'm going to turn around and go back the way I came, and then see there's that one little ledge there that I didn't check out earlier, so I'm gonna go check that out after this whole rock shelter excursion is over. But it looks like actually what we stumbled upon here, nice little, I guess it could be a climbing wall, we have a little ledge here, and it should provide us with a pretty interesting view of the area. Let's go over and check it out. So, wow, look at that. We've got water coming down and an excellent winter view of the gorge. There's snow blowing off of the trees. Absolutely amazing. Very beautiful. Very serene. So what I'm going to do now is turn around once I'm finished appreciating the view, and then I'm going to head back and check out that other lookout. So I've gone back to where I came from, and I've taken a right instead, and still some very beautiful rock faces here and rock shelters. We're gonna see where this takes us. And here we've made it. Looks like we have Devil's Canyon overlook. That's on Skybridge Road over there. If you're doing this, don't do it in the snow. I'm not gonna make the jump over this chimney top. But the view from behind that area. It's very, very nice, so I'm going to appreciate it from here. And unfortunately not today when it's a little slick. Maybe sometime in the summer I'll come check it out, but this is absolutely a remarkable view here at the Gorge. Look at this whole area, very, very nice. Very easy hike too, not too bad. Even if you don't want to climb down, you can still get a very similar view from up top where I was earlier. So this is definitely a 10 out of 10. I would recommend this hike, it's very fun. What I'm going to do now is hike back up to where I was and go back to the parking lot, and that'll be the end of the trail. So I'm going to turn around and then wrap up while I'm hiking. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in just a sec. And here again, just one more time, we have the arch that kind of forms. It's not a precise arch because there's a disconformity right here on the edge. So they're two separate rocks, but they kind of come together and form a nice little arch. And that's the way you come up and come back down. So climbing up was a lot easier than climbing down, which is nice. I am pretty much just on the little plateau up here, just going back to the parking lot. So overall, very excellent hike. Very easy as well. If you don't want to do the climbing part of it, it's even easier. So definitely a good one to do, and one to absolutely check out the next time you're at the Gorge. So very, very fun. I want to thank you guys for watching this video. I'm going to wrap it up here. You can check out maps of where I'm going, where I've been, at, I've got a new website, rrgmaps.com. So you guys can check that out in the video description. If you have any comments, questions, concerns, suggestions, you can go to the comments section down below. I'm heading back to the picnic area right now. I can see my car, which is nice. It's a very, very short hike, so you can get this done in a couple of hours. I got it, both of them done in two. I'm more like one and a half, but yeah, really not a bad hike. Definitely would recommend. So yeah, check out rrgmaps.com, where you can see not just this trail, but all the other trails I've been on. You can check out all my other videos too, so you can leave a thumbs down if you disliked it, leave a like if you liked it, and I'll see you guys next time.